Goggles reviews. Sorry, folks. Beer Goggles reviews Dominion. The guys from America have sent me some lovely, lovely beers down. Dominion and Fordham, kind of sister and brother beers like that. And not the sister and brother, I like that, hopefully. But anyway, you know what I mean. So we've got Dominion Hop Mounting. And there's someone up there mounting a hop. I don't know, there's a hop there. Hop bind, they've got hop binds, hop cones. Hops are basically, they're a flower. They look like leafy sort of things, but they're a flower. You use the female hops, are the ones with all the resins in, and also they're very closely related to Mary Joanna, lovely girl Mary Joanna. No, they're very closely related to marijuana cannabis there, Cannabisia something, what are they, Lupulus or something like that, but hops are related to cannabis, and I've been told from Gavin, who does the radio show, I can't think of his name, he's actually smoked them, and legally, I don't think there's anything illegal about smoking them, he's actually smoked the actual hop cones and all that, with the resin and everything else, and he said you can get slightly high on them. I don't know. I know you can get pillars with them in it, as a relaxant. The aromas coming off of those are sedative, and also if you get strong IPAs, the amount of alcohol in them that will get you drunk will be a lot less than in a malty drink. So if you get a big IPA, anything with big amount of hops, if you get a 5% IPA and you have the same amount of those as a 5% beer, Guinnessy sort of beer or something like that, without big loads of hops, you'll blum 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 blum. These ones will relax you as well as the alcohol, and that will, you know, same as if you're tired, you get drunk quicker, and the same with, you know, if you have hoppy beers, you get drunk quicker. You know, that's a fact. Yeah, it's probably not written down, but it's a fact. I've tried it out. Trust me. I do a lot of experimenting with alcohol. So, yes, hoppy beers get you drunk quicker. So, whatever you want to do. I mean, you know, people go, oh, what's the ABV? Which one tell was going to get me drunk quicker? Will I get drunk quicker on this? You get drunk quicker on different beers, different things. And it's different with different people, you know. Basically, what I say, though, and I know it sounds a bit poetic and all that, but what I say is that beer ain't about emptying the brain. It's not about numbing the brain. It's about feeding the soul. And if you get good beer, it feeds the soul. Whether you're, don't matter if you're drunk, you know, if you're blotto, what are you going to enjoy, really? You know, it's great when you're 20 years old and that, but when you pass 25 and that, you know, you've got to grow up a little bit and kind of start enjoying proper good beer. And really enjoying beer for the work of art that it is. And every good beer is work of art, and I'm jabbering on, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I get carried away. As soon as the passion comes welling to the surface, I'll get carried away, and I do apologise. I've tried so, so hard in the past to get my reviews to come down to sort of 6 minutes and 5 minutes and things like that, because apparently you'll get more subscribers and you'll get more views. And all that. Do you know what? If people don't love beer enough to put up with, you know, to listen to more than 5 minutes of it, me, if I've got someone speaking passionately about beer, I would listen. Someone like, you know, recently I did interviews with Carlos from the N2B, N Square B, Norfolk Square Brewery. I did interviews with him. And the guy's passion was so infectious that I could listen to him for the guy for 20 hours without blinking. You know, I could just listen to him, right, and not even bother blinking, breathing or anything. You know, it's that sort of passion. The guy's passion is so deep. And sorry, I've gone off the remit. Shut up, Tel, get on with it. Sorry. But what I'm saying is that if you love beer, you know, yeah, I know I should really shut up now and again. So I'm just tapping my bottle back in shape. I knocked it out, bottle top back in shape. That's it. Because I save them. There we go. I'm going to put a big backdrop with a load of them all across the back right there. With them all in order. But it's just getting round to it, you know. That's the little proud stag there. Lovely. Beautiful. Fantastic. Get on with it, Tel. Come on, Tel. Get on with it. This is Hop Mountain Pale Ale. And we are talking... not massively bottle conditioned. Whoop, stop. Right, tiny bit of bottle conditioning, which I will be pouring in later on, because I like to taste it with some in and without. And I've noticed 99.9% of the time, it's better with it in. You do get a noticeable difference. Right, that's what we look like with a head. There he is. Now you can tell a lot from how it sinks down there. And you can also tell a lot from tipping and doing that. If it grabs on the glass, it's going to hold on a bit longer. If it stretches a bit, it's going to kind of be quite stretchy and have a good, better mouthfeel. Sort of. Now it's stretched, it held on a little bit. So it's going to kind of go down gradually. It's going to go down the sort of fairly, not quick way, but it's going to go away at a fairly sort of, I don't know, a decent rate. I like that. I don't want it to be there forever. Excuse me. Right, it's twirling one more, and we'll have a sniff this time. So get a good twirl right up the sides of the glass, as high as you can get it up. It's kind of, when you're twirling, just do that, but gradually. Get it there, like a little queen wave, like this sort of thing, but going round and just twirl it round from underneath. You get used to gradually get it further up as you go, and you get used to kind of getting it quite near the top. Get it as near the top as you can. Get a good smell, boom, stop, go. Right, now you'll be noticing, if you've done that, if you've got the same beer, you'll be noticing big blood orange. Try these things. If you're going, what's blood orange like? For Christ's sake, try one. Go and get a blood orange. If I say, oh yeah, bergamot, bergamot. If I didn't say like Earl Grey tea. Have a smell of some Earl Grey tea. You go, you know, whether you like the tea or not, I love the tea. But buy a little packet of Earl Grey tea, a couple of quid or something like that. What's that? Even if you don't drink it, just sit and smell it now and again. God, bloody hell, yeah, he's right. if I say things then, and you've got an Earl Grey tea, you can go and get it and go, oh yeah, I can taste it. Yeah, get your point in it. Yeah, similar taste and smells in it, you know. Things like Werther's Originals and things like, I mean, that's not really Werther's Originals. It's got a slight hint of toffee. But certain things like that, you know, and the breakup toffee and things like that, that you hit with an hammer. Go and buy one of those, different things. Just buy one. If you ever kind of go, well, what's that off? Try different things out. As well as trying beers, one of the very important things about beer tasting is also to try the flavours that people are describing, you know. So if someone says, you know, it's certain dry strawberry smells in there, you know, get the dry strawberries. One of the places you get dry strawberries, if you look in the kids' breakfasts and things, you get like so-and-so, the flavoured this and that, and you get little tiny bits of dry strawberries sometimes in them, you know. Oh, here we go, and there's one. And you'll get this, and smell them as well. Smell everything. If you pick up, you know, my sister, she picks up anything, she'll get a pair of, like, a shirt or something, and we'll smell it in the shop, and then you go, what the bloody are you smelling it for? It's just, I don't know, just smelling it. But it's experiencing the world with more than one sense. So smell it, hear it, everything. Experience the world with more than just your senses you got as well. I mean, I can get around. My missus, she's blind and she's astounded that I can get around with a pair of those like glasses that you get that for letting sighted people know what it's like to be blind. And you can put them on, and I can get around, walk around. I can hear where things are because I used to do different martial arts and things like that. I've kind of taught myself to listen when you can hear like something next to you, one ear, and you can hear something there. You can hear certain things. You can hear the world. Once you get used to it, you can hear where things are without looking at them. Things like that. You know, sorry, I've gone off the remit again. But experience everything. And experience everything with all of your senses. If you pick up a fruit in the shop, smell it. Squeeze it slightly. No, don't go mad, but just squeeze it slightly. Smell it. You know, you'll know if it's ripe or not. When next time you try it, you go, I did that before and it had that smell and it wasn't ripe. Next time you go, ah, it's got that unripe smell. And then you go, oh, that one's got the same smell or something that was delicious. That sort of thing, and you get to, you know, you get to bypass the bullshit, if you excuse my very blunt language. Right, I am very blunt, but I kind of, I tell it how it is. I know most people to say, I speak honestly, most people to say that are just rude, you know. But I try not to be rude about it, but at the same time, I try to speak as honestly as I can, you know. Right. Oh, wow. That's resinous. It's thick and chewy almost. I can imagine that. I can imagine kind of fruits bleeding, chewy stuff coming out of them. Different fruits. You got bitterness there, but you got bitterness with grapefruit, with a little peppery edge, but with apricots, mangoes, a tiny bit of pineapple, passion fruit. Big, resinous, chewy. Imagine it like running down a tree like amber and chewing it. Chewing that sort of bitter, sweet edge. Oh, it's wonderful. Well, hold on. Malts. Let's talk about the malts. The malts are covered. And it's a wonderful thing with brewing when you've got big hops and that. But the malts are an important flavour in there. And they do make those bitter edges very sweet. And they make them fruity. They make them fruity instead of just, you taste a hop on its own, you go, like that. Even the loveliest, you know, the Citra hops and all that, like that on its own. So you need those malts to balance, but the malts also should have a flavour. Now in this, you can smell there's malts in there as well. You can smell little malty edges. But they are quite almost covered with the with these big fruity notes and big big chewy resins. Right, let's go down. Cheers. Lordy, lordy, Miss Clody. Right. Woohoo! Yep, big, big, big. Big, big beer. You got big fruity hops in there. Massive fruity hops. We're not talking fruity, we're talking fruity! Yeah, that is, it's kind of breathtaking almost. That is massive hops. But you've still got the malts in there. Toffee, tiny little, not quite enough toffee to kind of balance, but little toffee edges. It's like there's apple in there. Right? Imagine the apple in there with a wispy, thin bit of toffee over it. And someone saying, there's your toffee apple. You go, where's the toffee? You know, and you taste it. And the toffee would play a part in the toffee apple taste. But the toffee needs to be a bit more robust, I think. A pale ale. This is a pale ale. It's not an IPA, it's a pale ale. It's massively hopped. It's a pale ale that's massively hopped. We're talking massively hopped. It's big. It's a big pale ale. Personally, I would say I'd put it in the kind of realms of an American IPA sort of thing. It's big. It is big. But it's big in a lovely, delicious way. A parallel. Just a parallel. I'm not sure how it works over there. I really don't. It's a 6.3% ABV. Alcohol by volume. Yes, it's parallel. I always thought parallel was a different thing altogether, but that's a massive parallel. I think an American IPA at the very least, but it's an American IPA. That's a really fruity, big, massive parallel. But listen, I ain't complaining. That's delicious, and I know it sounds like I complain a lot about fruity beers. I really, really, fruity beers are one of my favourites. One of my favourite beers. I love fruity beers. I love big, fruity, hoppy beers. I also love big, lush IPA, Imperial Russian stouts, things like that. I love the big flavours. But also, I know that there's a place for the best bitters and things like that, and the milds and things like that. And there's a place on your menu for those. And a lot of people, they ain't got a place on their menus, their personal menus for those. Whereas you should have. You know, don't just go, if you go to a festival, or if you go to a beer shop or whatever, don't just buy the big American IPAs. Don't just buy the big stones and things like that, and whatever else, you know. They're nice. They're really delicious. They make my mouth water just thinking of them. But the other ones are just as delicious. And it's kind of sometimes the Mona Lisa doesn't have to have her boobs out, if you get what I mean. You know, sometimes a work of art can be just so well balanced and so beautiful that she don't have to have her boobs out. She don't have to have plastic implants and be standing there with woo 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 and a big flag and all that business, you know. Sometimes it's more subtle things to beauty than that. But at the other end of the thing, that there is a beautiful is a beautiful American buxom woman. You know, that is, I don't know, maybe a Dolly Parton or something like that. That's a Dolly Parton. For me, personally, I find Dolly Parton is a beautiful thing. You know, not just for the boobs, but for everything about her. She's an intelligent woman with kind of all the stuff that works for you. Same as Marilyn Monroe. She knew how to work what worked for us guys. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. Boop boop be doop. Let's pour the stuff in first. Right. Last bit there. It's got the stuff. 12. Tiny bit more smooth. Not a lot of difference with that. A bit smoother and a bit less attacking, but really nice. And a drier finish. See you in the next one. Take care. Love is to bits. Look after yourselves. Love is two bits. Love is three bits, four bits, all your bits. Take care. See you in the next one. Biddly boo. We'll be right back.